That's a long ass time. Alright. Oh, alright, I made it a little late in the lane. I'm a dumbass. Oh my god, this is terrible. Fuck, I shouldn't have gone late to lane, now I'm getting fucked. Yeah. When you go late in the lane, in matchups where you need to get the early game priority, you can just get the creep advantage and then walk up and auto you, because they'll always get level 2 before you. I shouldn't have walked up far enough to get hit though. So, I made 2 mistakes. I hit Q so far though, so that's actually kinda saved me. Yeah, it's definitely saved me. I would have been in a. Oh, I have Evelynn? Sweet. Look how scared he is. Because we have Evelynn, it's really hard for immobile champs to do much. Holy shit, he plays so fucking aggressive. What if E was there? I don't think he saw E before he went in, I think he saw her right after. Who's their jungler? Master Yi. This gank is really hard. Would have been much easier earlier when he was actually pushing up and being aggressive. Now he's being rather passive and getting pushed in.
An ally has been slain. Enemy double kill. An enemy has been slain.
I'm gonna have to get level 5 here too, so I threw spell. I'm in a better spot right now. Dorn's is the overall better item. Have if you're no potions, then it's better for me because I have sustain and mana regen. Damn, I need to stop throwing out charms. Their jungler's missing now. Asking for help because Jace is low. I'm about to get level 6. The only thing that can stop me from getting a potential kill is gank from Mastery. He has Ignite too. Yeah, this is a kill. Out of mana, I'm sorry.
An enemy has been slain.
Got got the early large rod. Yeah, I like Chrissy Gustanza. She is cool. She's a good singer too. I think coffee's actually too hot right now. I have no flash, no ult. Ahri's really cool down your line. People consider her mobile champion, but when your ult and flash are down, she's even more prone to getting ganked and killed than other champs. If you consider a mobile champion like Syndra, Ahri without ult and flash is much worse than Syndra, because Syndra actually has more CC to escape and she's generally tankier. Ahri's pretty squishy. I'm pretty squishy right now. So I'm waiting for my ult to come back up, calling him missing. Oh, he's back. Generally, I just ping missing using the MIA ping, and then when they return lane, I just ping them. Like, I just click ping them, so people see that like, I'm pinging him that he's back in lane. Then I don't have to write MIA or re. I do it just with pings instead. Thresh is roaming from bottom. They're all on bot side, even Master Yi's there. They're blowing a lot here. Nice. I don't know when his next cooldown's up. Probably not for a while. Oh wow, how annoying is that? Oh, is that Arriven? No, she can't do anything. I knew that roam was coming though. So it wasn't that big of a deal. Wonder if he's taking this. Sweet. I'll get an early DFG now. With the build path I got. The early large rod. I get insane wave there too. Look at this. Oh wait, never mind, I have to be level 9. Oh, this is actually bad. Yep. Ahri without ult is just a fucking awful champion. No matter how far ahead I am, I can't do anything without my ult. He also had red buff. I'm still ahead, so I should still be fine in this lane. I'm not building any armor, which is kind of greedy. So, what I didn't want to tell you guys was I actually just gave him blue because I knew I'd get it back as soon as I came back to lane. Gave me a free buy and it would essentially give me more overall time on blue buff. Kappa. I'm kidding, please don't. Please don't do that in a real game. Guys, I just died to him because I want to just get the buffs back. That's what I did. Let creeps die. It's better to let creeps die unless you need to fast push it and you have something to do like roam or anything like that. Because the more creeps die, the more you deny them, right? I should have saved my charm here. I got the charm on him. Knock up. Sweet. He says Q though. Right. We got dragon too. Let's peace out. Ult in 20. I want to push. I have a lot of sustain now. I can actually stay at ult soon. Was good. He was not expecting me to stay because I was chunk. That was Jace Flash. He flashed like 40 seconds ago, I would say. So around 17 Jace Flash approximate. God, the coffee's is way too hot. The old ganker on lane strat. Yep. An enemy has been slain. Double kill. Fuck, I could have hit that one. I miss him. Minwei's actually pretty competent mid laner, I'd say. I'm not sure who he is, but he's actually better than like most, if not every like random challenger mid laner. He actually punishes me for some of my mistakes. Like this game, he actually punished me pretty well level 1, and he also killed me when I overextended. Some people wouldn't have gone for that, because they're just like scared or don't know how much their champion can do. Oh, I'm not sure how this will go. 50-50 outside. Depends on my charm. Ah, she has ult. Never mind. Quadra killer. I am a quadra killer. Under Smurf? Nice. Oh god, whoops. Oh. I haven't really seen. Ult in 20, DFG in 22. You can see DFG cooldown right down here. Above recall. Eve is building Stalker's Warrior into Randuin's with Moby Boots. Telling him when my ult is up. My head is spinning. Every time I see E with a damn exclamation mark over her head, I always think like Rengar is coming. Every time she goes under to it, I'm just like, run! That's my first instinct is run! Rengar! Wait, there's no Rengar, it's the Sevilla. Let's see if they're gonna actually let us push. Yeah, it looks like they Holy fuck, the pony. Like a vampire. They let us end, guys. You know, it's fucking quirky. Learn some discipline. Oh wow. Should've let me kill him there. Oh my, the ward spam is killing my ears. Jesus. Stop. Oh, I had the game!